Fundamental Object Oriented Syntax. In this unit, we are going to discuss about the five lessons. Lesson number one, creating local classes. Lesson number two, creating and working with objects. Lesson number three, accessing methods and attributes. Lesson number four, implementing constructor in local classes. And lesson number five, implementing class constructor in local classes. So starting with the unit number one, lesson number one of the unit number two, creating local classes. In this lesson, you will learn how we can create the local classes. And generally, the local classes we can create using the SAP ABAP editor. And generally, the ABAP editor we can open with the help of transaction, which is SE38. So you can see in this example of a class, as I have already told you in the last unit, the class we can represent in the UML like this one. The first component generally represent you as the class name, and other component, second component represent the attributes. So you can see that, and the third component represent the methods. So here we have a class vehicle, and this vehicle have the attributes, and the attributes are public as well as private. And these public, private, and protected are called access specifiers. So when we make the component as a public, that means anyone can access the class public components. That means the outside of the class, the user can access these public components. But when we declare the component as a private, then the outside of the class cannot access this private component. Only the method of this class can access the private component. So you can see that the private component we generally represent using the red color, and public components we generally represent using the green colors. Okay, now you can see the third component, that is methods. So the method which are operate onto this data are implemented, and for implementation of methods we need to define the methods as well as we need to define the implementation part. So now come to the next topic. In this slide, you can see how we can define the class into the SAP systems. So firstly, if you want to define a particular class, suppose in my example, you can see we have a class local vehicle. So firstly, we need to write the syntax here like this one: class, then class name, and then definition, and then end class. So here the class and end class are the keywords, and definition is also the keyword. Once you have defined the class, you need to define the implementation part. So how we can define? Again, the syntax is class, then class name. The class name must be same that we have taken in case of definition, then implementation keyword, and then end class. So this is the representation of defining the class in ABAP editor. Now come to the next topic. An example of attributes. Now the second component of a class is attributes, and I have already told you the attributes may be either public or it may be either private. For a vehicle, the attributes may be make, color, or motor type, and so on. And one more thing that I want to tell you, if you create an object of a class, then this object can refer, that means refer means can access the public component of a class. Once you have created the object, you can access directly the attributes of the class. One more thing that I want to tell you about this creating of the objects: before creation of the object, we need to create the reference variable. So in the next chapter, you will see how we can create the reference variables. So before creating the object, we first need to define the reference variable, and by this reference variable, we can create the object. Now come to the next topic. Now this is an example of defining the attributes, types, and the constants in a class. So firstly, the syntax of defining the class is, first of all, the class keyword, then class name. Suppose in my case, the class name may be LCL_vehicle. Then definition keyword, then we can define the attributes. Now how we can define the attributes? With the help of data statements, type statements, and constant statements. And generally, when we declare a particular variable, that variable, when we are declaring this variable using the data statement, then these variables are called data objects. So here we can declare these variables by using either the local type, either the global type. Global type means dictionary type, or either we can use the like additions. Similarly, if you want to declare the variable, suppose you are creating the reference variable. Reference variable means if you are creating the pointer variable, then you can refer, type refer to the another class name. Suppose this is class local vehicle and we have another class rental. So you can also refer to another class by using the syntax type refer to class name. Similarly, you can also refer to the particular interface. And similarly, you can also refer to the particular type. So by this way, you can define the attributes. These are the attributes and then types and then constants. Now the next part, you will see how we can declare the methods. So before declaring the methods, you can see we have two types of attributes, public, private. Generally, we have the three kinds of attributes and the third attribute that is called protected, and that protected we generally use in case of inheritance. That means when we have the base class and then derived class. So for making the base class private component accessible to the drive class, then we use the protected component. And these are called access specifiers. So generally we have three access specifiers: public, private, and protected. So public attributes have the property like generally visible. That means within the class it is visible and outside of the class it is also visible. Second, generally changeable. That means you can change the values of these public attributes. There is an exception, read only. That means when you are declaring a variable, like suppose I am declaring a variable like this one, data variable one, type, then local type, then I am using the addition read only. Read only means then the variable one value we cannot change, just we can read out. So we have another addition, and that addition is called read only. Generally, public attributes are changeable, but when we use the read only addition, then we can only just read, not write there. So no changes are possible when we use the read only addition. Second is private attributes. I have already told you the private attributes only visible within the class. So outside of the class, we cannot access the private attributes and only changeable within the class. So this was the example of the visibility section of the attributes. Next, how we can access the private attributes? As you can see in this, we have firstly defined the a class local vehicle definition, and in published section we are declaring the variables mb underscore make type string, mb underscore model type string, and this is your private section. Now if you see, it is showing the faces, dull faces. That means there is no security. Why this is no security? Because in public section, when we declare the data, these data or attributes can directly accessible outside the class. So there is no provision of the security. So we firstly want to be the make this data variables into the private section. And generally we do that. Actually, the main purpose of using the object-oriented programming is to secure the data. How we can secure the data? By making or put into the private section. When you put it in the private section, you can see the smiley face. That means now the data is secure. So outside of the class, the private data cannot be accessible. But if you want to access this private data within the class, how we can access? With the help of object or instances. So come to the next topic. Comparison of the instance attribute with the static attributes. Now generally we are talking about here the attributes. So we have generally two types of attributes. The first one is instance attribute and second is static attributes. Instance attributes means when you create an instance, that means when you create an object, and then that object can access the attributes of the class. So that type of attributes are called instance attributes. Another type is static attributes. These generally static attributes are the attributes that once you have defined and initialized the value of that variable or data, that will be the same for all the instances. Suppose you have created an instance or object, and you have accessed this variable gv underscore n underscore o underscore vehicles, and we have initialized its value equal to 10. So one object has initialized the value to 10. Now when we are creating the another objects, suppose we are creating object 2, object 3, object 4, object 5, then the for object 2, 3, 4, 5, the variable value, that means gv underscore n underscore vehicle value will be the same for all of the objects. But that is not in the case of instance attributes. So this is the basic difference between the instance attribute and static attribute. The second difference, you can see how we can define the instance attributes or normal attributes with the help of data statement, but static attribute we can define with the help of class data keyword. This is class, then hyphen, then data. Okay, so this was all about the comparison of the instance attribute, the static attributes. Now suppose the object 2 is changing the value of this variable, then what it reflects? It reflects the same value to the other objects. Now come to the next topic, instance attributes and static attributes in program context. Now you can see the example of this one. In this figure, you can see this is an application server and this is an internal session of the application server. And you can see we have the global data objects are there. Now, in the second figure, you can see we have the variable n underscore o underscore vehicle. That means this is our static attribute. And you can see once we have created the object r underscore vehicle 1 and the value we have assigned is 3. So the value of 3 will be the same for all of the instances. When you are creating the r underscore vehicle 2, for this again the variable value will be the same. For r underscore vehicle 3, the value will be same. That means the static attributes exist only once. So any number of instances you created, the attribute value would be same. Now suppose r underscore vehicle 2 is changing the value n underscore o vehicle equal to 4, then the value for r underscore vehicle 1 and r underscore vehicle 3 will be the 4. That means once you have created the static attributes and once you have initialized the value through the object, that value will be reflected to the all other instances of the class. So this was all about an example of the static attributes. Come to the next topic. Here we have discussed about this, how we can create a class and how we can define the attributes. Now the next topic is how we can define the methods. Now again, this is our class, then class name, and that is your definition. How we can declare methods with the help of keywords methods and then method name. Suppose the method name is sum, and we can use the interfaces here. In my case, interfaces are importing, exporting, changing, returning value, and then exception and raising. So we have number of interfaces are there by which we can import the value from the main function, export the value to the main function, or by using the changing. So how we can define with the help of methods keyword. Once you have defined the methods in case of class, you need to again define this method. That means how the method will react and how method will change the value of the attributes and how method will operate on the attributes, that you need to define in the implementation part. That means the working of the method we will define in case of implementation. Or in case of definition, we just only define what type of method we are going to use and what are type of the parameters. But how the method will work, what method will return, how method will react to the attributes, that we can define in case of implementation part. And when we use in case of implementation part, we use the statement method, then method name is sum, and then we always ended this method with the end method. Okay, so this was all about the syntax of methods, how we can define the method in case of a class. Now visibility section of the methods, that is the same thing. if you are declaring the methods as a public, that means it is accessible outside of the class. User can directly access this public methods. And when you are defining it as a private, so you cannot directly access the private method, but with the help of calling of this method into the public, you can access these private methods. That means once you have defined the public methods and private methods, in public section of these methods, you can call the particular method of the private section. Then user can access this public method, and by this public method, he can call the private methods. So this was all about the visibility section of the methods. Now accessing private methods, this is an example of the previous slide. You can see we have discussed about this one, how it can access the public and private. You can see in this example, suppose this is our class and the class name is LCL_vehicle, and this is definition, and then public section we have declared the methods, because this is a definition part, so we are using here the keyword methods, not method, and the methods set_type, and then importing parameter IV_make_type_string, IV_model_type_string. Then we are defining the other method in the private section. This is private section methods init_type, and these are the attributes MV_make and MV_model. Now, once you have defined the class, we need to define the implementation part. And how we can define? With the help of implementation keyword. This is our class, then class name, then implementation. This is first method that we are going to declare, because this is a private method. So we can define how it will work. So method, then method name, init_type. Then we are declaring the variables MV_make, MV_model, and then end method. Another method, that is our public method set_type. So you can see here we have implemented this method. So this method cannot be directly accessible init_type, because we have declared this method as a private. How we can access this private method? We can call this method into the public method. So when we are defining this method, public method set_type, method set_type, if IV_make value is initial 0, then we can call the method init_type, which is a private method. So for accessing the private methods, we need to define the public method. In this public method, we can call directly the private method. And then else, and then one thing that I want to tell you, once you have defining this in the implementation part method, we need to end with the end method. So by this way, you can access the private methods. Come to the next topic, comparison of instance method with static methods. Similarly, we have discussed about the static attributes and instance attributes. Similarly, we have two types of methods, that is called instance method and static methods. The simple method that we are declaring in the last, you can see we have declared here set_type, init_type. So these methods were instance method. And if you want to declare the static methods, you can declare the static method with the help of keyword class methods. Okay, so this is class local_vehicle, then definition, this is public section, then methods set_type. This is set_type is our instance methods, because we have not used the keyword class method. When we are using the class method, that means we are going to declare the static method. So get_n_o_vehicle is our static methods. And the same we can do in case of, you can see, once you are defining this static method in case of definition, we need to define the keyword class methods. But when you define how it react, how it will work, how it execute the instructions, then in case of implementation part, you not need to define the class method keyword. You just use the keyword method, and the method name will be the static method name, and then the operation that you want to perform. Okay, and then end method. Now, one more thing that I want to tell you about the static method. The static methods can only access the static attributes. Okay. So we have designed the static method generally specially for the accessing the static attributes. You can see if we have declared this is private section. In this private section, we have declared the data. That means data means this is our simple data. That means these are the instance data, instance attributes. Now, when we are declaring this GV underscore underscore vehicle in class data, that means we are declaring here it as a static attributes. Now you can see this static methods get underscore and underscore vehicle is operating on this static attribute. So static methods generally work onto the static attributes, not to the others. Now come to the next topic, visibility section and UML notation. Visibility section, we have already discussed about this. We have generally three types of visibility section. The first one is public, second is private, and third one is protected. In the general programming, we use generally two type of access specifiers. You can say we use the two sections, public section and private section. But in case of inheritance, we use the third type of section, that is called protected sections. Now, how we can represent this public section attributes and private section attributes in case of UML diagram? You can see this is our class. This is class LC underscore vehicle. In this, we are using public section. In this public section, we have declared the methods. This is our instance method, set underscore type. And this is our static method because we have declared using the class methods keyword. Now come to the private section. You can see we have declared the attributes. This is we have declared with the help of only the data statement. That is, this is our instance attributes, MV underscore make and MV underscore model. And we have declared another attributes with the help of class data. That means this is our static attribute. And in private section, we have also declared the methods. This is our instance method. Now, how we can represent this class into the UML notation? You can see the first component in the UML diagram, a class represented using a rectangular box. The first component represents the class name. And you can see the class name is LCL underscore vehicle. Second component that represents the attributes. Now, you can see what we have the number of attributes, MV underscore make, MV underscore model, and GV underscore N underscore vehicle. So we have three attributes. So we have defined here three attributes. Now come to this one. Once we declare these attributes in case of private section, then we use here the minus sign. Minus make, minus model, and minus N underscore O underscore vehicles. So you can see we have declared these attributes in case of private section. So we have used here the minus sign. Now the MV underscore make and model, both are the instance attributes. So we need not to be use the underline here. And once you are declaring this static attributes, so we need to define it using the underline. And all of are in the private section. So we use here minus. Now you can see for the methods, third component generally represent the methods, and we have mainly three methods. The first one is set underscore type, second is get underscore n underscore o underscore vehicles, and third one is init underscore type. So we have declared these two methods in the public section, so we will use here plus sign. You can see set underscore type is in public section, so we are using here plus. Get underscore n underscore vehicles, we have declared into the public section, so we are using here plus sign. But this is class method, that is your static method, so we use here underline. Now the third method we have declared in the private section, which is init underscore type, so which we have declared in private section, so we will use here minus. But it is an instance method, so we cannot use the underline here. So this was all about the UML notation of a particular class. Now come to the next topic. Lesson number one of the unit number two has been completed here. So before proceeding on to the next lesson, lesson number two of the unit number two, the most important that I want to tell you about the difference between the static method and instance method, static attributes and instance attributes. As you can see, we are using here the class. That is your class keyword. Class methods, class data. Why we are using this class? Because these method we can only access with the help of class names. That means we no need to create the object for accessing these methods. By using the class name, we can directly access these methods. But in case of instance attributes or instance method, we firstly need to make the object. And with the help of object, you can call the instance method. Now we can take an example. Suppose in case of a Java, you can see we declare the main function, and we declare the main function like public static void main, and then passing the argument of the string type. We are using here the static. Why we are using a static? Because in case of Java, how we can execute the program or compile the program, generally we use Java C and then space and then class name. So by which we are directly accessing the class, and how we can execute the particular with the help of Java and then space again the class name. When you declare this Java and then class name, it automatically call the main function. Why it is automatically call the main functions? Because we are not creating the object, we are directly calling the main function, because we are using here the static. And static allow the methods and attributes without creating the objects. Only with the help of class name, you can directly access the static methods as well as static attributes. But in case of instance method, normal method or instance attributes, you can not directly call the these components. You firstly have to make the object, and by which object you can call the instance attribute and instance method. So this was all about the major difference between the instance attribute and the static attributes.